Reality is apparently beginning to sink in for some of those in the MAGA world who invested in Truth Social. Now, regardless of all of the claims that have been made about the company and its profitability and how Donald Trump is sticking there, it isn't going well. You can see every day the undeniable fact that it is not worth nearly what it was when these people bought into it. And you know, some people I'm sure are making money. Trump in the end will make some money. There are people who are shorting the stock. But we have to bear in mind, there are people who like Trump, who trust Trump, who just genuinely thought this was a good investment and they poured money into it. And now, including on Truth Social, they're talking about this and they're giving interviews like the Washington Post. And we want to reveal to you some of what they're thinking as they process what's happening day to day. So you have messages like this, can't help but feel sad, but I know in the end we will be celebrating huge wins. It sounds like crypto people, honestly. Can't buy more at this time, feel like I'm trying to catch a falling knife, which is just terrible as a metaphor. Oh, come on, DJT. Every time I buy more, the price drops more. When will it be the bottom? Probably when he cashes out. Whatever you put in is just going to him, man.
Yep.
This is painful to stomach. The stock has been cut in half with no signs of finding a bottom. 100%. The company has lost between $3 and $4 billion in the last month. Lost. It was never really worth that. But now it's not even like fake worth that anymore. And in response to this, some people are confident. Devin Nunes, you know, chief exec for Truth Social, or the company behind Truth Social, says there's not another company out there that has retail investors like this. He's very happy about all the retail investors. The poor MAGA people have been duped. Bear in mind, Devin Nunes will earn a $1 million salary this year, a $600,000 retention bonus, and a stock package currently worth $3.7 million. And to put that in perspective, what Devin Nunes will be paid is worth more than Truth Social. It's more than they will profit in the entire year. So yeah, I get why he's excited, but I don't think regular people should be. And they're processing it in different ways. And I want to describe a few of these and then we'll discuss. This one guy, Todd Schlanger. So he's, I guess, a fan of Trump. He's an interior designer. He's invested about $20,000 and is buying new shares every week. And hey, he can buy more for the dollar every week because it's worth less. Anyway, he says it's got to be political why it's dropping. It's all the liberals that are trying to knock it down. So it's a conspiracy. It's not that it's not actually worth anything. It's all the libs. Some of them talk about it in terms that have nothing to do with stock. They say it's basically a fight between good versus evil. Investing in the stock and seeing all your money evaporate is a way to defend Trump from the liberal elites that are laughing at them. One user said the fight has been long and hard on most of us, and this stock is, quote, not for the weak, but that one day they would triumph over critics who are brainwashed beyond repair. And you see a lot of this, the idea that this is not about making a rational financial calculation for you or your family. This is about throwing money at Donald Trump to stick it to Satan or something. And I look, I understand that many people are going to laugh at all of these people. And I get it. There have been warning signs for decades that Donald Trump is a con man. But I try to have some compassion because they have been deluded by the media and by influencers and grifters and all that. And this is not just that they're losing their money. Families are going to lose their savings to this. Kids' college funds are going to be gone. The chance that they'll have an inheritance will be gone. Marriages will be broken up over this because a lot of people unfortunately put their faith in a guy who has been nothing but a con man for literally decades.
Francesca, yeah.
What do you think?
Just that thin line, right, between businessman and con man, right? Between having a white collar job and being a white collar criminal. And Donald Trump really exposes that. I mean, just incredible. Like this person, like the projection is also part of the pathology, right? Will be proven right from the people who've been, quote, brainwashed. As I funnel more and more of my money into a stock that is, everyone can see, just tanking. Like, who's been brainwashed here, buddy? I'm sorry. Like, even if Donald Trump is reelected and he, you know, like single-handedly like ups the value or somehow manipulates the market, do you think that you're gonna make all your money back? Like, I guarantee you that even if he installs some sort of one-man dictatorship, like buys the federal government buys the stock market, that even then, these poor rubes will not get their money back. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, that's what they're waiting for. But again, and I love this, like, Oh, you just told yourself that the stock market was liberal? The stock market was sort of responsible.
That's a great point.
That only 10% of the American public even owns stock, but yet is responsible for tanking, you know, millions of people's retirement funds and their lifelines and their futures that are all resting on it. Oh, wow. You are truly lost. And I agree with you, John. I do have a lot of empathy for them.
Yeah. Yeah. I feel really bad, especially for their family members. You're gonna have a lot of people posting on Reddit about how, you know, their father lost all the family's money because of True Social. Sad.